Greasy, oily hair is very annoying, and it's a thing a lot of our viewers have to deal with at some point. So if that is you on the regular, there may be a way to find relief. That's what we're here for. Sal is here with a special guest to explain what it is and how it works. So, Sal, number one, training your hair is actually a thing, right?
Believe it or not, Tracy, it is a thing. And it's not a CrossFit and a protein shake kind of thing, right? It's a thing where, which basically, basically involves training your hair so that it can be less oily and that you can wash it less throughout the week. Okay, so right off the bat, you got to note there's various reasons why we have oily hair. To name a few, it's our age, it's hormonal changes in our body, it's perhaps products that we're using that are not agreeing with our scalp and hair. And then there's the biggest complaint that I get almost every day in my chair, and that's I wash my hair every day and it's still super oily. And that's the problem, and that's where the hair training comes in. But I do got to note that hair training is not necessarily for everybody. People who have always been prone to, I guess, greasier hair and skin may have a hard time achieving success with hair training, but we can definitely talk about some products to help get you through the week, perhaps not washing your hair every day.
Okay, I like that. We actually have one of those success stories here with us right now. Hey, Breanne, great to have you. Your hair looks great. Can you tell us why you decided to start training your hair?
Thanks, Tracy. So I've had my hair colored for a long time, and that mixed with, I work out pretty much every single day. So I've got dry ends, oily scalp, and my hair is kind of overprocessed, so I tend to, and it's very like limp and flat, so I always tend to curl it. So there's been a lot of damage that's been going on. And I just figured, what can I do to help? And I was on a Zoom around December with my girlfriend, Sandra, and she came on with this beautiful hair. And I said to her, what have you done differently? I said, did you wash it different? She says, oh, it's been about 10 days since I washed it. And I said, excuse me, how? So she told me there's this thing called hair training. And I figured, what better time, Mike? So I began the journey.
Oh my gosh, it is working for you, girl. So I am intrigued. Sal, can you explain how to start training your hair?
Absolutely. So first and foremost, Tracy, you want to make sure that you set yourself up with success with the right product. So good shampoo and conditioner, probably a sulfate, sodium, paraben-free one is always the best option to go with. After that, the hair training process kind of just involves a little bit of patience and changing your routine at home. So how I usually recommend people to do it is to take it in 1 month intervals, okay? So it's we believe that it takes a month to gain one extra day of no washing when you're washing every single day, okay? So just so I can explain it better, so what that would look like is if you're washing every day, you would switch to kind of a day one, day two schedule where you wash and then don't wash the next day. What you're gonna notice in the first half of the month, you're still going to be quite oily. It's gonna require at least a couple weeks for your hair and scalp to kind of balance and regulate to your new schedule, and you'll start seeing some better days towards the end of that month. And then if you wanna continue this, you kind of take it in another month interval after that. Because ideally, I'd love you to be washing your hair once, maybe twice a week. I know it's not obtainable for everybody, but you definitely don't wanna do every day, that's for sure.
Yeah, no, who needs that headache? So, Breanne, what was your experience like training your hair? And do you have advice for people who are thinking about trying it?
And so I went from washing my hair every 3 to 4 days to now I wash it about every 13 to 14 days, and like Sal said, like, you just have to have patience with it. Like, when I get to day 4 or 5, it's kind of questionable still. I'm like, oh, can I do this? But you kind of just know, and you learn over time that your hair will get it. Your scalp will kind of understand what it is that you're trying to tell it to do. And I use a shower cap now. So when I'm in the shower, I put my hair in a shower cap. So these, like, all these little things, you kind of learn along the way.
Breanne, you're like moving towards becoming a black woman. Shower cap in the shower. You got probably like a silk scrunchie on at night. I love it. Like, soon you'll have a bonnet and then it's just, you're just part of it, right? You're part of us. So we at home, like, we wash our hair once a week for me and my daughter. And a lot of black women have that. We have a wash day and it's usually Sundays. So it makes your life a lot easier. But Breanne, you're doing even better with 14 to 17 days. My goodness. So people at home are wondering, no, I'm impressed. People at home are wondering what their hair will look like when they try their hair training. So Sal, do you have any tips for keeping your hair looking good when you start washing it less?
I do, and that's actually a great question, because like I said, you're not going to love your hair in that first week or so of not washing on your regular schedule. So your biggest tool there is going to be products, okay? So three main ones that I would recommend for this is a dry shampoo, a texture spray of some sort, and a hairspray. Now, I recommend these products because they are drying products. They are products that absorb any excess oil in the hair. And then how you apply them is very important as well. Like, for example, I've seen my wife and numerous people actually just apply dry shampoo that looks something like this, and then they just kind of shake it up. It's not really targeting the areas that you need it to target. So the biggest issue that you're going to have when hair training is the buildup of oil in your hair at the very beginning. You want to access that to make sure that it absorbs and your hair gets some life and bounce back into it. Kind of just sectioning it and spraying it into each section is probably the best way to do that.
Oh, this was a good conversation. Thank you, Sal and Breanne. That was really good. Now, if you want to give hair training a try, head to our website. Good stuff. For all of Sal's instructions, we're going to put them there for you.